Good evening. This is Dr. Priyadarshini, Assistant Professor, Department of English, KCS Kasinada College. The topic we are going to see today is the welfare state. The welfare state deals with the impact of two world wars and how the English economy was affected and what were the steps taken by the Britain government to make the people come out of the sufferings like unemployment, and they faced some issues like they couldn't pay for their health services, and they also faced many untold problems like they lived on streets, their economy went down, and there were so many problems for common man. And how the English government takes various steps and brought, you know, so many acts to eradicate the situation, and how England once again became a welfare state due to these policies which were brought up by the Britain government. We are going to see how England became a welfare state in this video.
The World War One and Two has devastated United Kingdom. After the destruction, England decided to rebuild itself. So it has brought Social Security and the Welfare Act to improve its country. The Social Security is different from welfare state. Actually, the welfare state refers to government programs which provides money, medical care, food and housing for the people who are economically weak. Through welfare state system, people receive welfare which include their children, aged people, the handicapped and others who are not able to provide for themselves. As soon as Second World War came to an end, Labour Party came to power with Clement Attlee as the Prime Minister of UK. In their electoral manifesto, they promised to provide program of social services and nationalisation. Nearly 6 years after the war, England became a welfare state under the Labour government. They passed numerous acts to ensure social security and welfare for the people. Some of the important acts they passed were: they nationalized the Bank of England, the coal industry, electricity, inland transport, gas industry were nationalized. Including that, they also brought National Insurance Act, Family Allowance Act, National Health Service Act, Housing Act, Education Act, New Town Act to improve the condition of their country people. Through nationalization, many industries were brought under the control of government. The private owners were given compensation and the control of the industry came under the state. Nationalization can be done only through an act of parliament. Labour government did it successfully. When the Labour government came to power, it nationalized the Bank of England in 1946. They also brought coal industry under Nationalization Act. Nearly 800 mining companies were brought under central regulation. Not only that, civil aviation, cables, wireless and electricity and gas were also nationalized. Adding to that, railways, harbours, transport also brought under government control. Inland transport were also nationalized. This act of nationalization provided a security of job to the people who are working in. It reduced the unemployment problems. The National Insurance Act was a social service program brought by Labour government. According to this act, every adult had to pay a small sum to the government. Equal payment is done by the employer or for each employee. These contributions amounted to about 30% of the cost of the insurance plan. The rest of the money was given by government through the general taxation. Through this insurance plan, they gave weekly payments during the period of illness and unemployment to the people. Through this act, old age pensions were given. During emergencies such as pregnancy, childbirth, widowhood, and death, they paid the money to the needy. The National Insurance stepped forward with helping hand. The Family Allowance Act. The Family Allowance Act provided small sum of money to every family for each child except the first one until the child grows up to 15. The National Health Service Act. The National Health Service Act provided free medical and dental services to the people who are in need. Not only that, they provided free glasses, dentures, and also prescription for medicine. They included hospitalization too. This Health Service Act was very flexible. It allowed the doctors to continue their private practice. Through the scheme, the government improved the general health of the nation. Families were relieved of the worry of not being able to afford medical help in case of illness. Two Housing Act was passed by Labour government. They did it because many houses were destroyed during the First and the Second World War. The First Housing Act prohibited private building and encouraged the construction of low-priced houses so that people could live in a cheaper rate as paid as rent. The Second Act, the government encouraged the improvement of large city houses, which almost degenerated through subdivision into apartments and cheap lodgings. Though in the beginning, the housing acts were criticized by opposition parties, but within the 5 years of time, nearly 8,60,000 permanent houses were built, and also 1,50,000 temporary houses were built for the poor. And not only that, they also built 3,33,000 new units were created through the conservation of older dwellings. This almost solved the problem of housing in England. The government of Britain brought Education Act. The government had ambitious plans for education, but they were badly handicapped due to the shortage of trained teachers and inadequate school buildings. The government made an attempt to train teachers, and also they raised the school leaving age as 15 years. And they also provided assistance to universities and students to improve the quality of education through this Education Act. New Towns Act. According to this New Towns Act, the government decided to build new industrial and residential towns on the outskirts of large cities because they want the people to not to live in the congested areas, especially the urban centers. So this helped people to move to the suburbs. Effects of Labour Party. Within the 6 years after the World War II came to an end, the social services were greatly expanded, unemployment was vastly reduced, sufficient income to meet the cost of food and shelter was guaranteed to all, free medical aid was provided, the housing problem was solved to a large extent, and education became more democratic. There was a greater concern for the welfare of the population as whole. We can say, within the few years of Labour Party came to power, the England became a welfare state.